Right, well, ladies and gentlemen, this is the race that we didn't run last night. Geelong 18, Tony Grimstead on pole. Geelong 22. Oh, Gavin McKenzie, of course. Sorry, Gavin. Danny on 12. Geelong 23, Johnny Kikinilowitz. South Australia 63, Kim Cottrell. Mick 1, Peter Timberlake. RD 10. Cara Bruce Tate. Wimmera 24, Nev Simmons. RD 64. The car of Bob Morrow. Avalon 19, Gary Drew. Redline 21. David Alford. Wimmera 34, Greg Carter. Wimmera 5, Neville Elms. B 46. John Rodder, Alexander 75, Dalton, Wimmera 29, Chris Wild, Hamilton 15, Ross Mill, B 40, the car of Philip Herbert, G 28, the car of Steve Ryan, HA 88, Ray Hammond, and Redline 28, the car of Bob Whittle. Now those of you that I would assume that most of you were here last night, the ones that are here early, or you may have just heard our advertising on 3HA 980. But due to the lateness of the hour, we had to cancel this event last night. We had three restarts under in 5 laps, and the rules of racing decree that it wasn't an event, so we decided to rerun it tonight. Now, of course, the same field that you've got out here, plus perhaps a couple of others, are going to race for heats and to qualify for the English Challenge, Celtics English Challenge, so the first of the two features. It was very fast racing last night. 22 come out here and ran quite quickly. Tony Grimstead, Johnny Kanilowitz, Peter Timberlake, Kim Cottrell. And all these guys ran really fast. So they're rolling around now, and starter's hands now for the Hamilton Bull City Cup. Grimstead, McKenzie, Conrad, Kanilowitz, Timberlake, Cottrell, Kanilowitz, Tate, coming out of straight away, and they're all Cottrell. We've got a big one here. Oh, we've lost a lot of them. Well, what a... That's what we didn't want to see first up, because we've got two heats to run tonight. But we've lost one. Well, I don't know, having a look there at the cars, Tate's the only one that hasn't moved. Thank you. Geelong 18, Tony Griffiths there. Geelong 22, Gavin McKenzie. Dandenong 12, the car of Rod Nash. Then we've got Johnny Canella with Kim Cottrell's out. Peter Timberlake will be beside him. We should have Redline 10, we've lost him. Avalon 19, we've lost him, I think. Redline 21. We lost him. Wimmera 34 is next. Wimmera 5, Ballarat 46. Alexander 75, Wimmera 29, Hamilton 15, Ballarat 40, Geelong 28, HA 88, RD 28. So now we're in the starter's hands. Looks like it'll be Timberlake and Grimstead this time. tell these front runners they're
I don't think
that'll be any problems with these guys. But Grimstead claims the corner. He shuts right down on Timberlake. While they're tangling, of course, this is it. Ryder goes round the outside. One lap to go now. Grimstead slowed, so he could have done it higher. He's probably a bit lucky that he'll get around in the... Oh, we've got Alexander. Well, I don't know. I thought it was pretty exciting stuff. Put your hands together, ladies and gentlemen. My first feature for tonight. The Wall City Cup from last night. It's all pretty confusing, isn't it? But, the winner, we shall tell you in 2 seconds.
We actually lost the winner.
Right, well, we had 46 the winner there from John Rodder. Second was Vic 1, Peter Timberlake. And third was Shalong 18, Tony Grimstead. So, give John a big hand as he comes around there. So, he's taken the first bonus for the night. That's the Wool City Cup. Give him a big hand as he comes around, does his lap of honour. Victory lap. And you're going to get a second serve on for the English Challenge. So I suppose that's pretty good, really. It's a bit of a bonus, isn't it? But no doubt the cars will go out, and hopefully they'll be back to run the heat. Mainly tyres, I think, seem to have been a big problem there. Gavin McKenzie's going, so I don't... In 31, and Michael Golding in 17. So it's pretty greasy out there in the first race. It's Trevor Good in 41, but it's Rob Bowen, the lead car. Let's see how they handle the greasy track. It's probably going to be a little bit slow, usually it's the first couple of races. And it's Wal Hucker takes the lead down the back straight away.
Stop, that's the flat moment. Oh, he's made a bruise. Well, he's in.
So around they go, and there's Ross Burrows spun out on the first lap. And the conditions a little bit slippery. This leaves Wal Hucker. And good, Trevor Good is around. And we've got Michael Golding sliding around. So this guy's finding the track a little bit greasy. And they're letting them go. So it's Wal Hucker, the lead car. Then we've got Laurie Wilson up there in second place. And Golding in third. Sean Clark there in 27. Ross Barrows now up there in 66, and Damien Smith there in the 31 car, Michael Golding in 17, and Trevor Good in 41. Wal Hucker doing it pretty well out there in HK12. From Laurie Wilson there in 43. And it won't take long for the track to settle down by the look of it. Sean Quayle and Ann Golding, and Golding going up now into third place. Ross Barrows there in 66. Damien Smith's having a little bit of trouble getting his handle. Michael Golding goes around Trevor Good there now in the 41 car. And Wal Hucker comes around again. So the lead car, Wal Hucker, Laurie Wilson in 43. HA12 the lead car is a very slow. Oh, and Wilson around over there, but he'll have time to correct it. And the 27 back in front of 6. So we can't watch all the moves, but I'm sure you can. And still Wal Hucker to the front runner. From 17, the car of Michael Golding. No, sorry. Laurie Wilson in HK43, the second car. Then we've got to go back to this bunch of cars down here. Sean Clyle, Dan Golding, and Ross Burrows. Kenneth, so I'll hack it. From 43, the car of Laurie Wilson. And I think we're still back to Sean Quayle in third place. Burris on fourth and Golding in sixth, and they're finding it pretty hard going. Across the side of Gordon and I.
And we've got
four cars going down there, but it's Watson. Another couple of rounds, pace, and we'll keep going. But Fastest lap was 23.42 and no race time because of the stoppage. Right, we'll see the second heat and we should have Brian Sparrow on pole. MHA7. Withholding nomination, so we've got 77. Brought to you, of course, by our good friend Coach.
Yeah.
smart ass!
Thank you. Second flight.
Gotcho, Quimstead, and Temple Eight. Because of the stubbing. Kim Cottrell from Adelaide. Keeping the Victorians of Brimstead and Timberlake behind him. This time we should have Gavin McKenzie out there on the pole for position. Avalon 19, the car is through. Back to the chief status. English doing well there, closing up. So I've got a bit of evasive driving there. They come round for one lap to go for the lead car. That has got into the wind. Going for the outside run. But we've got a couple of lap cars up there and that's going to stop them. It's going to be a pretty good finish. What will happen here? They're behind Tiny Smith.
Car.
Ben, we've got Josh Wayne back there. Cochrane in 78, Wayne in 6. And we've got four cars back here fighting it out for the point. The 23 cars, Robertson, 19, 77 Golding.
Oh, no.
AK-40, Neil Watson. And leading the Brig Raider, continue to round. Get around here. Right this time. Anthony Wilson, the A-grade car on pole. Outside in Ballarat, 66, the B-grade car. In three, we've got Mortlake 14. The route number, using the route number, not to confuse the two cars. Mortlake 14, the B-grader. On his outside, I think it's Neil Wobby Watson. Back in five, we've got Wimmer 6, John Clayton. And we'll pick them up as they come up the lane straight away. Craig Fox in 15, Laurie Wilson in 43, Lloyd Wallace in 28, Nyora 78, Cara Cochran, and 41, Cara Trevor Good.
We should be out there.
Oh, and that's the field. 16 cars contested the Coast Coal, and thanks to generous support of Coke. Good response to the Speedway. Down. Calix English Challenge. Now, thanks to Peter and Joy Robertson and English Transport for once again bringing this to you, the big annual English Challenge. Just waiting for them to sort themselves over there. 18 on pole. Looks like 23. Canelo is outside pole. They'll come round now and for the English Challenge. Tony Grimstead on pole. Johnny Kanilovic will be outside pole, I'd imagine. 22, Gavin McKenzie. 46, Rodder. Rodder. Jim English in 5. Looks like Kim Cottrell in the 63 car in 6. Gavin McKenzie, Dalton back there in 75, Carter in 34, Wild in 29, Saul 7-9 in 5th, Hammond in 88, then there's Bendigo, Redline 10, Snell there in 15, and Ryan in 28, so we've lost a few of the top fancies there, I feel. Timberlake Blue on motor, I believe. So there you are. 12 super sedans out of the 22 survived, so there's 10 in the pit. We just hope they can keep it all together. When the flag drops and all hell breaks loose. Carter pulls to the outside. Down the back straightaway. It's Canelo from Grimstead. McKenzie up there in 22. Canelowick leads Grimstead around to McKenzie. Right, then we've got Cottrell, English, and Tate. From Dalton, Carter, Tiny Smith, Ryan, Chris Wilde, and Ray Hound in the 88 car. And Snell going around there in the Corolla. It's Grimstead to the lead. From Canelowick to McKenzie. And then we've got Rodder, Cottrell, English, Tate, Carter, and Dalton. Already they've broke the field up. So let's go back to the leader. This is where the place is. This is where they fly. Grimstead. Down in front. From Canelowick. McKenzie. Then we've got Rodder. Cottrell. English. Carter. Kate. Dalton. Ross Snell there in 15. Tiny Smith back. Bring up the rear of the field. We've got the ball for TK88. It's Grimstead. Then we've got Chris Wilde. Johnny Canelowick. Gavin McKenzie, Rodder in 46, Cottrell. Gap in the field there to English and Carter. We've got a race in the hands here, ladies and gentlemen. 25 laps for the Calix English Transport Challenge. Grimstead, they're serving the way through the field from Canelowick. Then we're back here to Rodder and Cottrell in 63. Jimmy English in 8, James and Carter. Then we've got Stoltz. Back to the base of the 10 car. Now they come again, it's Grimstead in 18. Then we've got Canelowick with a mighty little trophy master from McKenzie, Rodder, and Cottrell there in 63. Spread out around the track in 16. Straight away, and unfortunately, Grimstead clipped him. and flatten the tyre. Well, that's right, and they go. We had the same thing happening to Cockrell in the previous six feature here in the first round. So commiserations there to Tony Grimstead. Well, around they go, let them off. Camilla is going to be right up there in third place. Then we've got Cockrell. Getting a little bit untidy there, but we'll line them up as they were if they're going.
Seven laps down.
car. From Kim Cottrell there in the 63 car with the 7 car being left. Car going around the outside. Cottrell taking the run on the outside because he's got to get out after Rotter there as soon as he can. Hammond going through. So it's Rotter the leader. I'll tell you what, he mightn't be as fast as these other guys, but he's ran for two nights. Probably rear of the field as Ross Snell, but he's cruising around there in the little six-cylinder Tirana. We've got three of these big fire breathing V8s left. We've got 10 cars in the middle, would you believe? You probably counted them yourself. But if one of these cars then doesn't finish, Ross will be up in third place.
She spread fairly well.
That was spread for.
She's a battling to drive that.
Well, I suppose this will be a well-deserved win there of Cottrell's if he does win it, because he was leading this race back on February the 14th and blew a tyre. So he's come all the way down from Adelaide to entertain you. Congratulations to Kim Cottrell from Adelaide, third time lucky. And big hand, big round there for Kim Cottrell, ladies and gentlemen, all the way from Adelaide. Had this race won on the February the 14th when he was forced out with a flat tyre. And I think that's a well-deserved win.
Sometimes they go down, sometimes they go up. Now, second place, second time for the night. John Rodder, I'd say Hamilton must be a good track for you, and I guarantee we'll see you back here again.
I'd like to thank the Hamilton Speedway, and I've had a pretty good day. Thanks.
Good day, good night. Right, and give me a lot of pleasure to present this one. One of them, they call over the Crowiers, don't they?
Crowiers.
Come over here and show all those guys how to do it. We're pretty sympathetic the first time we were over Kim because you might add a bit more of this, but you've got it this time. And we do thank you very much for coming over. And if you'd just like to come up here and get your sash.
And more important to you, the check.
That's right.
$5.
Thank you very much.
Yeah, English Transport's going to tell us.
Well, I'd like to thank Hamilton Speedway, Jim English Transport, and Caltex. They've put the money up, so without them, I don't think Hamilton could run a tri-city or tri-state,
tri-star.
I've enjoyed it very immensely. I like coming over to Victoria to race with the other competitors. They're good competitors. I'll like to come back next year if they keep having the try star. I'd like to thank my fiancée, Anne, and my other mechanic, Stephen, for coming down with me. We have to go back tonight. We're working tomorrow, we don't have holidays. I'd like to thank all the other competitors, Rodder and Ron Dalton, and see you next time when we come back. Thank you very much.
Big hassle we have, Kuma's drivers change addresses too many times, we can't catch up, so keep in touch.
Thank you.
But the big hand drivers and everybody else for these three drivers, they've really turned it on. And we must mention the Hamilton guy, Ross Snell. He stuck to his guns in the little six-cylinder and came home in fourth place. So just showed what a little bit of steadiness, and well done, Ross. And thanks to all the drivers that have made the weekend a success. But don't go yet, because we've got the Coca-Cola Stampede to give out the sashes for. So we'll do that straight away. I'd like to thank Coca-Cola for their support for this meeting. And ask the following drivers to come up. Neil Wobby Watson. Wobby Neil Watson. Whatever you want to call
it.
Yeah, as usual. The big two, Anthony Wilson. Max, come on down. Incidentally, I was talking to some of the drivers earlier. I reckon Fitz the fourth race meeting. They found the source of annoyance that's put the 12 o'clock curfew on. It's Max Carlin, he's copper too. Apparently, Max staying home this morning. He's 5 o'clock, he's going to cook and carry the copper too. Right, I'm Brian in third place in the Coca-Cola race. Hamilton 40, Neil Wallen. Second Wilson, I think we'll call him. Well, but then again, somebody's got to come second. All the best. We won't hold against you if you come from Ballarat.
Thanks, all. Thanks to Coca-Cola for putting the race on. All the sponsors. Approved. My wife, Dan, Steve, Greg. Thanks to all the other guys who helped me out. And congratulations to Max and Neil. And the Craig's wife.
Just like to wish all the drivers all the very best, because the next time we'll see them, we'll probably be up there at Mildura for the Australian title. And I know there's a strong following of Hamiltonians, Portonians, Horshamptonians, and Ballaratonians. All going up there probably to see these guys, and perhaps one of them could be a winner. There's a bloke got pretty good backing to come second, hasn't he? We won't put a jigs on him. But we'd like to wish you everybody going up to the title all the very best, and Norman Fisher and all the guys down there. And thank you all for racing here at Western Speedway. It's been a fantastic weekend for us. When we sit down and count the gate date, we hope it will be very successful, because we're already looking ahead to next one in Texas. Late over again in 4 months' time, and hopefully we can come up with something really spectacular to top off our 20th season of racing here at West Speedway. I've got no more to say, I've had to say for the last few nights. Thanks very much for being here. We had just my favourite party. Enjoy yourself. Thanks very much.
See you
on
April 1st.
Hello. How low do you go with that?
Yeah. So she's beautiful. Really beautiful. I'll keep it. Deb wants it on her tape. No, put it on our tape so we can show it.